Two boxes, Goombas, then the three boxes. Okay, two boxes, Goombas, then three boxes. You can't bounce off the Goombas in this one. Let me show you. See, that's me holding jump on the Goombas. That was a Mario 3 invention. We out this bitch. Already did that one. Too easy. Grab the goal pole. Potato pancakes go pretty hard. Can't disagree. Here's what I'll say about potato pancakes, though. The flavor is amazing, but the amount of work it takes to get to that amazing flavor, I find prohibitive on all except the most holy days. You need like a whole morning to be open to you to get to the point where you're like, I'm going to make latkes this morning. But if they have an option for them at the restaurant, that's pretty close to a like pack one, pick one for a guy like me. You can't go into the pipe. Okay. Turns out you can't go into the pipe. Applesauce or sour cream? I'll just go ahead and say it, man. Dealer's choice. Dealer's choice. Whatever you got, I'll take. You got both? I'd probably go applesauce just because of the novelty of it. You don't eat a lot of foods with applesauce in the modern day, or at least I don't, except for when I have my wisdom teeth taken out. So give me the applesauce on that one. I don't mind. That's the speed tech. That's the slow tech. Fuck you. I don't mind an applesauce. Fuck you. There's a lot of foods like that. I mean, again, I don't think I made my point very articulately yesterday. It's in 99% of circumstances is going to be cheaper for you to make a food yourself with ingredients from the grocery store than to DoorDash it. However, there are some situations where like if you want to make like a burrito bowl, having all the ingredients in the burrito bowl that Chipotle has is going to force you to spend more than you would spend on one burrito. And then you're going to have to eat like seven burritos. Now, the thing that I think millennials and boomers get wrong is they're like, why don't you just eat more burritos? The thing that the DoorDashers understand but don't articulate well is they're like, I don't want to eat a week's worth of burritos. I just want to eat one burrito. I don't want to like structure my whole life around like one grocery purchase. So I think there's room for both is all I'm trying to say. Well, it's a new PB, but we got room to go. And in keeping with that, there's foods, as I mentioned, that like I'll cook some of my like not favorite foods for dinner and save some of my favorite foods for when we go out, man. I'm done making tacos and burritos at home. Unless I don't know how many kids you have to get to the point where you use all of the ingredients you buy for one taco night in one taco night, but we're not there yet. I'll just get it when I go out to a Mexican restaurant. I'll get a burrito for lunch if I'm flying solo or something like that. And then at home, I'll have food that's like pretty good, but not maybe my favorite food, you know? I'll have some fusilli and marinara sauce with some Italian sausage or something like that. It's a more economical use of ingredients. Well, I guess this is growing up. Hang on, my ass is reluctantly crouched at the starting line. No, I'm not, a little slow. I'm focusing. I'm gripping. That's adulting. It is, I think. That is not a song about jerking it. That is a song, because it's on the Peloton playlist. In my head, that song is about a guy at a bicycle race who comes in last, but he still wants to finish the race. And his wife is like, please, please copulate with me instead of just biking. And he says no. But he does it for himself. He doesn't He doesn't do it for the glory because there's no flowers, no flashbulbs, no posters, no lines. He's haunted by a past he cannot define. Bowel-shaking earthquakes of doubt and remorse impale him and assail him with monster truck force. You know what I'm saying? In his mind, he's still striving, still making the grade. She's hoping in time that his memory will fade. Tough luck. Are you kidding me? I thought that was S for sure. Sigma's finish last? Yeah, we're like, sometimes not at all if they're on SSRIs. I hear. Go, 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 go. Too slow, too slow. I don't think the speed tech gets any speedier than this, man. For me, the speed tech doesn't get speedier. Yeah, I like Cake. Cake definitely one of the bands where I like the band more than the thing they're named after. Pavement? Well, I don't know. I guess like, Pavement's kind of an unsung hero. I gotta give Pavement its due day on the catwalk. They do make it easy to, like, walk. On the street. That's valuable. Vinny likes Pavement. Sure he does. He seems like a man of taste. You have to go outside, though. That's not a Vinny-related thing, but... What about Phoenix? I gotta think about that. Are you talking about the X-Men, the concept, or the city? I'm pushing my streamer dolls together to make them talk. Good, good movement tech, man. Bar for bar, frame for frame, line for line. Fuck you, Goomba. You should listen to Phoenix. Yeah, I was like 21 in 2010, so I definitely have. I know all about fucking Listomania and 1901 and fucking whatever, the other ones. And nothing against Phoenix. Fuck you, Goomba. What about Marcus Phoenix? Is that the bloke from Gears of War? He's juiced. I don't respect him. He's juiced. I had to slow down, man. That was close. He's natty? There's no shot he's natty, man. Good genetics. I don't care that he's juiced. I just think it's like a bad example to be setting for all the little kids out there that look up to Marcus Phoenix. That he's lying about being juiced. Like, nobody cares that you're juiced, man. Just like, admit it. You're like 58 years old. Who's winning? This is brutal, man. You gotta be fucking perfect on this shit. Oh! We talking about Hugh Jackman? I got nothing against Hugh Jackman. Do I think that he's on some form of hormonal enhancement? Who am I to say? What do I know? I'm just a guy. I couldn't say, legally speaking. I will say, I don't really know what you look like when you're on steroids, because like, you see people on steroids that work out, and you're like, that's not natural. You're on steroids. But then, like, I'm sure there's a lot of dudes out there that just look like normal guys, but they're, like, on steroids for some reason. Like, what percentage of steroid users, like, also just skip going to the gym? There's got to be some, right? Oh. Or maybe there's people out there that are like, you know what? This is a little unethical life pro tip. I actually think steroids are a good way to stay on your gym routine, because like after you inject yourself with test in your butt cheek, like it just keeps you honest because you're like, I already injected the test. So like, is that, what am I going to do? Skip the gym? So for me, it's not even like about the gains. It's just about like the mental routine of like not giving myself an easy excuse. Like if I didn't shoot the test that morning, then like maybe I would be lazy and I would be like, I don't have to go to the gym today. I didn't take my steroids. But because I took my steroids, like, yeah, I've got to go to the gym. It's just like, it's like having an accountability buddy, man. That being said, I don't really care if you're like on steroids. It's your life. It doesn't really bother me. Now, do I think that sometimes it's kind of funny? Yeah. But lots of things are funny in this world. Oh, I was on the perfect line too. It was a line that the likes of which I've never seen before. This shit for the damn birds, man. Is it faster to take the pipe? You can't take the pipe! It rewinds you! Yes, you can. All right. Honestly, this is gonna feel good. Get ready for your 600 second timeout. First, I gotta not die to the Goombas, but you're all gonna pay, okay? That's the important part. What's it like to be 37 years old and finally realize you don't know everything? It's a lesson a lot of people learn a little earlier in life. I'm gonna let you off with a warning on that one. A lot of people never learn it, so I'm not saying you're behind the curve. You might be like right on the curve. You already left? A lot of people can't face reality. You wouldn't be the first. 600 seconds, no vowels. NL, is this just because you're too lazy to look up and see his username? Yeah. Yeah, you cooked me on that one, that's for sure. Hang on, I think I'm up a little. Dude. This shit is impossible, man. I don't know if I could, I don't know how much I could, there must be a routing issue. There must be a routing issue. Because I don't think I slowed down on that one. The one thing I could think of is like, higher on the staircase. Like, if I could take the upper path on the staircase and thus hit the pole closer to the top. Like, that's what I'm looking for there. We didn't have to slow down, so we're on pace. Okay, we're in there. Talk less, smile more. Fuck you. What should I eat for lunch? I don't know what you got, brother. Should be what you got first. Don't say nothing and then ask for me to tell you what to get from DoorDash. That's between you and God. I don't want to know. That felt that felt like we were kind of in there. That's the hole. Don't hit the question mark blocks. In Goomba Town? Don't hit the question mark blocks in Goomba Town. Okay. That's not what you were asking for, I'm assuming. Just touched down in Goomba Town. 10 kills on the board right now. I know what you're talking about. Chug Jug with you. Fuck you. You need 21.16? That seems criminal to me. 21.16? Good, good. You're on pace. Hold. This shit is hard, man. It's getting very satisfying though. I'm feeling like I'm a lot better at Mario than I was a week ago. Just kidding. What's the time save? It seems like such an infinitesimal amount of time that I think the secret might be like, don't blink. Or like, hold your breath or something like that. Whoops. Well, we're all cooked now. Centa frame loss. I think maybe if you hit the second block on the top of the stairs, you can hit slightly higher on the pole and save yourself 0.2 seconds. Turn the middle side topwise. Okay, Rubik's.com. It's some dumb shit. Well, I think this is like the perfect speed run, right? Because this one, it doesn't feel like there's like a trick. It just feels like you gotta like be neurodivergent, to be honest. And I'm doing my best. I'm eating the same thing for breakfast and lunch every day. Like, what more can I do, man? What more can I do? Go. 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 Hit the question mark block. It's all for naught now. I was like, the last frame on the pipe, you jump, you land one block higher on the staircase. That gets you there. But it's going to take an absolutely flawless performance. A polished Polish performance. That's it. That's the one. Okay. I can't do it faster than that. That's as fast as I'm ever going to be able to do it. And that's okay. That's, as far as I'm concerned, that's perfect for a guy like me. Oh, here we go. Apollo's got the route for this, man. I saw him on his stream. He has the route. I shun fancy things like electricity. Fuck you. Can't break blocks. Fuck you. We're Weird Al posting now. I need Apollo's help. I need Apollo's help, man. What time is S tier in putting a toddler to bed? I don't even want to talk about it because we're not gonna we're not hitting the S rank in that. We're probably hitting B++ right now. My toddler falls asleep after me. It's kind of a sticking point in my life right now. B++, not bad. It's almost as bad as it gets. In this game, at least. At least the overnight oats are good. They've solved breakfast. I'm late to the party, but I think it's still early. Like, I think overnight oats, it's gonna be like government mandated that you have to eat overnight oats for breakfast by like 2026. How many blocks do I have to break? 20? I thought it was 15. Fuck you, man. Apollo was doing something like that. I just don't like this one. We'll come back. I watched Squeaks do that one for like an hour and a half. he's got more temerity than I do then. This, though, it's actually easier to be small Mario. Now, it's cope because I took damage, but also I remember this level from the legendary challenge. All you have to do is run and occasionally jump. I guess that's Mario to begin with, but, like, my muscle memory's for small Mario here. Like, we can definitely get this one. This one's easy. That's just pissing me off. Like, my muscle memory's not right for small Mario or for big Mario, man. Whatever. That's enough to get us to S tier. All we gotta do is land the jumps. I believe. Second and a half time save. Good staircase tech. Good enough. All right, they want a little more, a little more. Something like that is gonna be the way. Not that. That's gonna be the way, man. It's gonna be the way. Crouch jump is basically small Mario. You can't do running crouch jump in this game without letting go of dash, which compromises your time completely. See, you could let you carry some momentum, don't get me wrong. What do you think, guys? I'm faster. I'm faster. Hold. It's criminal. That's criminal, man. Oh, you could just run under. You just gotta be fast and maybe shoot a couple spurts out there. I didn't realize. Something to do with the frame buffering, no doubt. Yeah, that's it. Doesn't get any better than that. Okay. All right. Collect 30 coins. It's not necessarily my strong suit. So what do you got for me? Enter pipe 4 in the Horp zone. That ain't nothing but a peanut for a guy like me. I just want to give a shout out to how clean your stairs are. I've been practicing a little bit, like, while playing this. So, like, it's... My stairs were kind of decoded when we first started playing NES World Championship, but... You already know the vibe. Maybe it is faster as Big Mario to just go over the top. Or, you know, take a hit. You're right. Take a hit is the right way. Slide. Fuck you, Kirby. Take your hit there. Embrace the Goombas. Wow, I was at B speed! Oh, this was mind-blowing as a kid. You're absolutely right. You gotta take a hit there. Like, when you see Mario silhouetted against the UI, you knew you were working with a mad genius. Hit the block before last Goomba. Last Goomba. Brother, you can crouch? Why are you being so condescending, Stay 100? It's like a difficult task. When you see someone struggling with something, you should default to the idea that it's harder than it looks, because they got the same faculties that you do. If not, you know, I'm going to leave it at that. All I'm going to say is that some of us in our heads, we say the negative stuff to get that little jolt of like feeling superior, but then in chat, we just type NT, you got it next time. In chat, we just type, you're only ever 2 to 3 dodges away from beating Mesmer. You got this. Exactly. Look at that. I was thinking, though, I think sometimes I'm too hard on chatters. Can I come up with a hypothesis for you? I think it's possible that in other parts of the world, in North America, a lot of our communication is obfuscated. We dance around the point. We say things as nicely as possible. You know, we wrap the iron fist in a velvet glove. But because we're immersed in it, like when someone is like, hey, it would really help me out if you could come into work 15 minutes early tomorrow. If that person is your boss, they're basically saying, come into work 15 minutes early tomorrow or you're fired, essentially, or we're going to have problems. But then, like, because I know in Sweden, like if you have your friend over at your house, it's illegal to feed them dinner. So I almost wonder if there isn't like some European or Scandinavian like manners. And then when you learn, or customs, I should say. And then when you learn English, you just take the Scandinavian customs, but you didn't learn the North American like fake niceties that make the communication come across to us as like a little bit less direct and rude. The dinner thing is false. Judge? What the heck are you saying, brother? In Sweden, it's not what I heard is that if a friend's over your house for dinner, it's not considered customary that they also eat with you. Hang on, we're goated. Like, you might be like, hey, dinner's ready. You stay in my room and play my Xbox while we eat the chicken tenders. Yeah, I know. I know, Shigeru. That's fake news? I don't know. A bunch of Americans in chat are saying it's true. You said illegal? Yeah, I misrepresent things for humor all the time, dude. It's called, telling the truth. It's called spreading misinformation on the internet so I can giggle. It was literally just one guy. Yeah, one Swedish guy. Listen, the fact that everybody's getting mad at me tells me that I'm definitely right. Because if you had a problem with the meat of my argument, you would simply best me in rhetorical combat. But instead, you're resorting to what's called ad hominem attacks, which means your argument is weak, and if you suck at debating, then all of your opinions must by default be incorrect. That's how it worked in ancient Greece, and we ain't changed that shit up for like 2,800 years, so... QED. I own you, little bro. It's that simple. So, sorry. Tough luck. It's illegal to eat lunch in Sweden. You heard it here first. Oh, fuck you. You can bounce off before on the last block before the last two Goombas. Okay, here's... I didn't see your username, okay? So I need you to help me. I want you to point out the block here. Like this block that I just hit. Let's wait for Y's or N's. That's the one. I don't know. There's a lot of N's in there too. I just didn't do it. Could also kick the Cooper shell here. Whoa! You're absolutely right. Can you try the first pipe at the end? I'm giving you the benefit of the doubt on this one. It said enter warp pipe 4, okay? There's no trick on this one. The trick is you gotta do what it says. Okay, thank you. You're welcome. Just don't invite me for dinner, because I like to eat food. Tech. I'm not Swedish. Prove it. Have your mom cook me a delicious smorgasbord. We can do better. Break the blocks on the top? I think you could, but that's like... That's not my route. So I need to... I would need to learn a whole new route, which might be necessary. It's way slower? Okay. I mean, not getting hit would be sweet too, but I really just don't know, like, how we do it. I guess we need, like, full speed and then, like, a crouch slide. I don't know about that. Pretty sure Apollo did it your way. If it's good enough for him, then it's good enough for me. I mean, if he can do it, then I can do it. We got nothing to worry about. Speedrun tech. I think this is our slow point, man. Like, I think you need to miss the Goombas and not stall there. Take the hit. Hit the block. Fuck you, dude. I think you jump over... I think you're absolutely right. I think the trick is unfortunately going to be difficult. Hit the Goombas, or jump over the Goombas, land on the edge of the pipe without accidentally touching the piranha plant. You got to save the hit for the plants. Unfortunately, the reason I take damage is to... fit through a small gap, and the piranha plant comes after that small gap, so it's like a complete compromising of the route. So I think I'm gonna stick with this one until it fails. Good enough. Take the hit. Take the ride. Order the all-you-can-eat boneless wings. In fact, order two. Final Fantasy 14 harder than this? Nah, no shot. I've seen my wife do the raids in her static. You just dodge the circles, man. The hard part is probably getting, like, 12 adults together and then to, like, listen to one person without getting distracted. That, I trust me, I know more than most people how hard that could be. But the actual machinations of it, the red circles on the ground, I wasn't paying attention. They got me in a dental dam, fuck. You have been at the dentist a while. That's a long appointment. I feel for you. Did they give at least give you one of those, like, maybe that's what you're talking about? One of those, like, mouth holders so that your own mouth doesn't get tired of holding itself open the whole time? Yep, it's a game changer. That is great dental tech. A little earlier. It's like holding it open for like an hour or so. That's, I mean, it's mewing. You're mewing. You ever get a treat for going to the dentist? No, I'm an adult. You go because you're supposed to go. So what? I mean, you could leave the dentist and buy yourself a treat. No one's telling you you can't do that. I don't expect my dentist to treat Max me, though. I do that. I hear that. Anytime I have to go to, like, a meeting or something downtown, I'm like, fuck, I don't want to go to this meeting. But then after the meeting, I'm like, look at this bounty of lunch options, dude. And then I'd, like, usually check my phone, and I'm like, ah, never mind, I gotta go pick up my kid from daycare. But, like, just the thrill of all those possible lunch options is, like, that's enough of a dopamine hit to keep me going for a couple weeks. Me whenever I have to go into the office. I hear ya. It's adulthood in a nutshell. Okay, get ready. Oh, that was like kinda it. You ever pick up lunch after picking up your kid? Yeah, for some activities, like on the weekends when we leave activities around lunchtime, I'll take her out for lunch. That's a lot of fun. It's a good time. I've kind of been dad maxing. Took her to the arcade 2 days ago. Took her to the library yesterday. But like, it's got me Googling shit like fun things to do as a 3-year-old in Vancouver. And then like, I don't know, again, this, I'm not really pissed off at anything except like my life being like slightly more inconvenient. But I'm like, it'd be nice to mix it up and maybe like go to a museum or something like that. And then I look at all the museums close at 5 p.m. Like, how is that working out for you? No disrespect. And like they're open on Saturdays and closed on Sundays. Like, yeah, open at 11:30, close at 5. I'm like, well, I guess I'm not learning shit about like anthropology or whatever. That just doesn't fit into my schedule. You don't have to make it fit into my schedule, but it would be nice. Three-year-olds aren't working though. They're in daycare, bro. Sometimes museums have a later day. Yeah, but then, like, listen, I know the game you gotta play, but that, like, you know, once a month you can have a couple beers at the museum. I don't wanna take my kid to that. Also, I feel like that's like r/child-free's like safe space, so I don't want to like encroach on there. Me when there's kids at TELUS World of Science in the part of the museum where you play with toys that are made for kids. Sorry. I'm just causing trouble, I guess. Just causing trouble. Tommy need drinky. It's hard to slide, man. All you're doing is spitting facts. I just think that they should have the museums open later, okay? And serve beer. Yeah, but like, I mean, I'm kind of with you. But then, like, North Americans, I think we've proven that, like, we can't handle it. I think in Europe, they have, like, more decorum, maybe in some places at least. Oh! That was it. I think I gotta do, like, one more good try. And then go pee and get ready for Lethal Company, man. Washrooms and beer serving places are hell. I think I want to bring back Prohibition. And the thing that did it for me was seeing and having to use the bathroom stall fireworks night at the Vancouver beach. Like, it was sincerely, I was like, this bathroom is so fucked up that we actually need to like raise the drinking age to like 50 or something like that. Cause it's like people can't, they can't handle it, man. The sand is bad enough, but then like, the fluids and the smells and the drinks that were just left in the bathroom stall and the... I mean, it was just a mess in there. What if the 50-year-olds are the icky ones? Well, lock them up. I've used some pretty nightmarish bathrooms because my kid is still like, you know... It takes a while to learn all the skills you've got to learn to be successful with the potty. You know, like you got to learn, like sometimes you might not have to go potty that bad, but you do it at the place that you're at because the next place you're going to is unlikely to have a good bathroom. So you're like, if you're at a nice restaurant, you're like, hang on, before we go, I'm going to use the shitter. Because after this, you know, maybe we're going to the beach and I don't want to subject myself to that. Didn't Prohibition do the opposite of what it was meant to do? Nah, I think like if you watch the Ken Burns PBS documentary, like average American was drinking like 100 gallons of whiskey a year or something like that. And then like after Prohibition, it went lower and stayed lower. Now, it didn't, like, take it down to zero, which is fine, but it did seem to have, like, a lasting sort of, like, impact on consumption. Like, that's, I'm not saying we should really bring Prohibition back. I just think, like, they should maybe teach people how to use the bathroom and, like, arrest them if they do it badly. So I don't mind having a beer in a museum, of course. Okay, anyway, I gotta go to the bathroom and be back in time for Lethal. Okay, slash marker.